Very good morning. In today's class, we'll discuss about the order cypriniforms. Cypriniform means here the carps, barbs, minnows, all these are under the order cypriniform, and it is the largest freshwater order. Okay. Almost 3000 available species, and among them almost 1800 valid species are there. They all live in tropical and subtropical waters. They are greatly diverse. Mostly they are using in all food purpose and also ornamental purposes. According to Nelson 1984, this order contains almost 2422 species. The main characteristics are they have single dorsal, they have the cycloid scale means they are smooth in touch, their upper jaw is usually protractile, mouth usually toothless, but pharyngeal teeth is there. Branchiostegal rays are 3. In practical, already I have shown what is branchiostegal rays. In your right side top picture, it is also demarcated. What is branchiostegal ray? That is written 9 to 15. The 9 to 15 is for another groups. For carps, it is generally 3 in either side. Generally, adipose fin is absent. Adipose fin is present in generally in catfishes, except in some cobitids. Cobitids means they are called as loaches. They have the presence of kinethmoid bone, that is a median bone present in the ascending process of premaxilla. In your picture, see on red color indication is there. In front of premaxilla, it is this bone is present. It is called as kinethmoid bones. Another two main characteristics of carps are the presence of Weberian ossicle. Weberian ossicles means it is a structure that connects the swim bladder and the inner ear. That is called as Weberian ossicle. In your left side picture, see the swim bladder and the inner ear, that is sacculus, lapillus, they have there, the connection is there behind the vertebrae. Also, they have the physostoma spaces, that means they have the presence of pneumatic duct, that is the connection between swim bladder and the gut. If the pneumatic duct is absent, then it is called as physoclistus. Some fishes have the spine-like rays, osseous rays in dorsal fin, or in some species, an anal fin also, spines are present. Whether in your practically have seen any carp species with presence of dorsal osseous bone or anal osseous bone? Have you remembered? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Whenever you will come, I have arranged all the species. If any doubt is there, just came to the lab and just clarify. It is the common carp that have both osseous dorsal bone and osseous anal bone. So the main characteristics of the order cypriniforms are single dorsal, presence of cycloid scale, then Weberian ossicle, हेलो
यस
मतलब वॉइस इज सम इंटरनेट इश्यूज इज देयर दैट्स व्हाई द वॉइस इज ब्रेकिंग सॉरी सॉरी हाँ दिस
जियो
जियो है एक मिनट स्टूडेंट ऑन मिनट वेट करो थोड़ा सा पासवर्ड थैंक यू हेलो हेलो ओके 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 सॉरी सॉरी फॉर द डिस्टर्बेंस इट हैज द थ्री सब ऑर्डर कैराकॉइडे जिम्नोटॉइडे एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सिप्टिनॉइडे और साइप्टिनॉइडे दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द मेन सब ऑर्डर और कार्प्स बार्ब्स एंड मिनोस दिस सब ऑर्डर अगेन सब डिवाइडेड इंटू 23 फैमिलीज आई विल डिस्कस some major family whatever you have seen in local market or generally available in Indian coast I'll discuss about 11-12 main families like Ballitoridae Catostomidae okay like that the first family is called as Ballitoridae that is called as river loaches They have the main character. These are not that much of important. The most important one I will tell. These are lesser important. So the main characteristics is the pelvic fin either is separate or fused, and the inferior mouth with three pairs of barbels. They have 16 genera and 102 species. The example is. Ballitora brucei. Okay. Next, the fishes that is called as Catostomidae or suckers. Suckers are generally some sucker fishes are present in the aquarium also. Okay. Its distribution is China. Some sucker fish there is a modification of dorsal. With some fishes are there they have the dorsal fin modification but it has the mouth is sucker shape distribution is China northeast Siberia and northern America lips usually thick and fleshy with presence of papillae premaxilla and maxilla I've already discussed what is premaxillary bone what is maxillary bone okay what is mandibular bone Premaxilla and maxilla usually bordering the upper jaw. The example is Catostomus catostomus and Carpoides carpio. The next family it is called as Cobitidae or the loaches. It is important family. Its distribution is Eurasia. Eurasia means Europe and Asia and Moroccan coast. Its main character is mouth is subterminal with more than three. It has more than three pairs. That is, some fishes has three pairs, some has four pairs, some has six pairs of barbels also present. And a presence of small spine below the eye. If you see in magnification glass, this species. The erectile spine will be visible but you if you preserve the species in formalin sometimes this erectile spine may not be visible because this is a small fish and the spine may dissolve or may become soft okay. The examples are Bottia dario. You have seen this species in some aquarium also. This is called as Bengal loach or Rani loach. Bottia striata. Then Lepidocephalictis guntia. Guntia loach. These are the examples. In some aquarium, they have kept this Bottia dario and Bottia striata, that is called as loaches. Loaches are generally found in our Gangetic River, then your Mohananda also loaches is available. Some hill stream loaches are also there. Loaches is generally available in West Bengal and Bihar river basins. The next family, that is fourth family, is Nema chaelidae, that is called as brook loaches. It has only three pairs of barbels. There it is more than three pairs. It has three pairs of barbels and no erectile spine is present. In Cobbetidae, the erectile spine is present, but here no erectile spine is present and it has a huge diversity. Around 800 species is available in this family. The example is Acanthocobitis botia. The most important family among the order Cypriniforms are the family Cyprinidae, that is called as minnows or carps. Its distribution is Northern America, Africa, and Eurasia. That means all over the world it is available. They have pharynx with 1 to 3 rows of teeth. That means 1 to 3 rows teeth will be present in pharynx. Some has barbel, some has no barbels. Jaws are usually protrusible, lips are generally thin. Dorsal fin with spine-like rays in some species. The family Cyprinidae has around 10 subfamilies. Okay, all the carps, barbs, that is the subfamilies. Labioninae is there. By that name already, you can identify which species will come under this subfamily Labioninae. Next family is Cyprininae. Dide means family, Nine means subfamily. Next family is Barbinae is there. Then you have heard the name Trouts and Mohasir. They are the cold water species. Trouts and Mohasir, they are also carps. They are present. Then our barbs that you are telling, na, Java carp or Puntias, these are also, they are called as barbs. So the family Cyprinidae has 10 subfamily that includes 1763 species. The first subfamily is Labioninae. It is the largest family. Among Cypriniforms, the largest family is Cyprinidae. Upper lip in continuation with skin of snout. Okay. They have the fringe lip. Presence fringe means lips, means their lips is little bit rough is there. If you touch the inner surface of the lip, you will find the roughness. These are the main characteristics of the family Labioninae. So examples is Labio rohita. Okay. All our Katla, Rohu, Mrigal, these all are now under the subfamily Labioninae. They are telling na Bangana Dero. Sirenus reba, Sirenus serosa, Sirenus mrigala. Sirenus means mrigal. Sirenus mrigal means mrigal. Labio calbasu. Then your labio katla. Previously it was katla katla. Now the name changed as labio katla. If you search in Fishbase, they will show it is Gibelion katla. But now the modified name is labio katla. Labio rohita, labio bata. All these are under the subfamily labio nine. Labio contias, labio fimbriatus. These all are under the subfamily Labionine. The next subfamily is Cyprinine. The character of this is the presence of osseous bone in dorsal and anal fin, and the dorsal is behind the pelvic, or the dorsal is opposite to pelvic. The examples are goldfish, crucian carp, common carp. These all are belongs to the subfamily Cyprinine. There are three varieties of common carp. One is Cyprinus carpio variety communis, that is commonly called as scale carp. That means their entire body is covered by scale. The next variety is Cyprinus carpio variety specularis, that is called as mirror carp. In mirror carp, see, there are patches of scales, not entire body covered by scale. There are some patches they have covered with scale. And the last variety is Cyprinus carpio variety nudus, that is called as leather carp, that have no scale in their body. Nowadays the most popular, or they are telling that Amur carp, it is not a variety, it is subspecies Cyprinus carpio hematopterus. Okay, the third subfamily is Barbine. Barbine, just remember its example, that is Semiplotus modestus. It is one popular fish of Nagaland. It is the state fish of Nagaland. They have called this Nagbham. It is called as Semiplotus modestus. It is belongs to the subfamily Barbine. The fourth subfamily is Cyzothoracinae. Cyzothoracinae means they are the hill trouts. The trout species, the cold water fish trout, they are the under the subfamily Cyzothoracinae. Two species are there. One is trout, another one is mohasir. In trout, the scales are small. In mohasir, the scales are large. Okay. Example is Cyzothorax richardsoni, that is called as snow trout. Okay. All the photographs are also there in the presentation. The fifth subfamily is Taurina. Previously, all the trouts and mohasir are under the subfamily Cyzothoracinae. Now it is changed. New subfamily came, that is called as Taurinae. The examples are Taur mohasir, all the mohasirs. Taur, that is Taur mohasir, or there is brown mohasir. Taur putitora is called as golden mohasir. Neolistellus hexaconolepsis, that is called as copper mohasir. Okay. These all, you see, in mohasir species, the scales are large. Next subfamily, it is Smiliogastrinae. It is also new subfamily. Okay. All our Puntias species are belongs to this subfamily. It is also a species rich subfamily. Lower jaw covered with lips, mouth narrow. It has a very small mouth. Okay. The examples are Chagunias chagunio. There is the Osteobama belangeri. That is called as Pengba. This is also state fish. It is a state fish concept. I will tell you. Just remember, it is the state fish of Manipur. Previously, on single genera was there. That is called as Puntias. Now the name has changed in some species. Previously, it was Puntias conconias. That is rosy barb, most common in aquarium. Now the name changed as Pethia conconias. Like previously, it was Puntias ticto. Now it is Pethia ticto. Similarly, Puntias sarana was there. Now the name changed as Systomas sarana. Then Puntias sophore, that is called as pool barb. These common names you have to remember. Next family is Danionidae. Danionidae also, they are the popular aquarium fishes. The character is in Danioninae, see, dorsal is behind the pelvic. In Cyprininae, that is goldfish, and in common carp, the dorsal is opposite to pelvic. But here, the dorsal is behind pelvic. Remember this example. The species is Mola. You probably have not tell this species. This is also available in market. Mola, they are telling is Mola or Morla. The scientific name is Amblypharyngodon Mola. Then your Labuca. Previously the name was Chela Labuca. Now the name changed. Labuca. Berylius bendelensis. This species, the zebra danio, this is common in ornamental. Because in aquarium, most people keep one to zebra danio species. Isomas dendricus, that is flying Indian flying barb. See, in all species, the dorsal, presence of dorsal behind the pelvic. So if you find any species, they have the dorsal behind pelvic, surely it will be under the family Danionidae. Then your the trout barb, Rhymas bola. Previously it was Berylius bola. Now it is called as Rhymas bola. Probably you have seen this species in aquarium. Next family is Leucicidae. Just remember this example, Phoxinus. Then the family Genocypridae. So the example Genocypridae, it is very much important. All your silver carp and grass carp belongs to this family. It has 13 branched ray, anal ray, very small eyes visible from the underside of the head, caudal with 18 soft rays. The silver carp and grass carp and black carp, these are under the family Xenocypridae. Next is your Tincidae. The species Tinca belongs to this family. The next family, 10th family, is Psilorhynchidae. They have no presence of barbels and small gill opening. The example is Psilorhynchus species or Psilorhynchus ballitora. This is not that much of important. The last family and the smallest fish, that is called as Pedocypris progenetica, is under the family Pedocypridae. Previously, it was only Cypridae family. Now it has changed. It is, see the photograph. It is very, very small. 8 millimeter, 7 millimeter species is the only the total length of the species is 8 millimeter, 9 millimeter. Okay. The example is Pedocypris progenitica. Okay. So thank you. In today's class, we have learned the family of carps and in which family, which subfamily Katla, Rohu, Mrigal belongs, in which subfamily your Puntias belongs, your goldfish, then your silver carp, grass carp, common carp, okay, Danios, then your amblypharyngodon mola, then your trouts, mohasirs. Clear? Hello?
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello? Yes.